Hi everyone, welcome back to Red Blossom Tea Channel. Today we'll look at how to make tea smoked up. Here I have a dish of Lapsang Souchong. This is the main ingredient for smoking any protein, any meats, but today we have a couple of drumsticks for from the duck and duck breast. So for Lapsang Souchong, this is a black tea that's fully oxidized from Fujian. The tea leaves are more every day because it's harvested in the summertime and they're smoked with pine wood. Normally for a tea like this, it's commonly used to blend or it's used for adding milk into. For us, in the Chinese culture, Lapsang Souchong is often just considered a cooking tea. So we have teas like this that we spread out onto a pan, and I normally use a foil to cover the pan. Then we'll spread out the tea and sprinkle some raw rice on it, and then we'll add a little brown sugar. I use coconut sugar, and it'll create the fizz. So I would set up the oven to about 450, put the tray of tea on the bottom rack, and then place the pieces of duck on the top rack. So it's lined with foil as well, but we've rendered some fat off of the duck so that I could save the fat for Yorkshire pudding at a later date. And then we've salted the duck, place it in the oven for only 10 minutes. And here we have the duck breast slice. I've pickled some lotus root with a purple bamboo leaf. You could also use dragon well for this. After pickling it, it's nice and crunchy. So we have a bed of arugula dressed with some persimmon vinegar. I got as a gift from a very famous chef. And it has some olive oil, and I've sliced the duck onto here. And then of course, if you need a dipping sauce, you could also use a little bit of the Lapsang Souchong tea brew with a bit of the chili flakes. We use a little salt, a little vinegar, and sugar so that you can create that vinaigrette. That's very common in Chaozhou style cooking. They would, instead of smoking the duck breast, they would brine the whole duck into a soy mixture and then use a vinaigrette. And in this case, instead of using soy sauce, we could use a little bit of the tea. But for drinking, we usually would drink a uyi oolong that's of higher grade. So here I have the old growth shui xian from 2013. This is also nice because it has a nice nose, but it has a finish. So we could use boiling hot water to brew this tea. And this pairs perfectly with a rich dish like this. This is 80% oxidized, but it's charcoal roasted with longan fruit wood instead of the pine wood. So you see the whole leaf. And with these whole leaves, it has much more of a finish because it's a higher quality leaf. Now, of course, you can see the amber color. So it's almost like having a nice rich wine to go with a heavier dish. We also have some brown rice here with more of the pickled lotus and the dragon well tea. And this pairs perfectly. For this tea, drinking teas have more of a finish and not just the nose. So Lapsang is one of our most popular for cooking, and you can try our tea smoked duck at home, or of course you can use other proteins as well. If you want to read more about these two teas, Lapsang Souchong for cooking and the old growth for drinking, please visit our website, redblossomtea.com, and of course follow us on the YouTube channel.